In general, people find they're most similar to their immediate family because they're most related to them. More distant family members still show similarities, but fewer similarities than the closely related family. For example, you might compare yourself to one of your parents, say your mother, and you might be looking at traits that you share in common. And then we can look at your mother's parents, one of her parents, let's say her father, your granddaddy, and we could essentially compare the same traits among all of us. And we can keep going back in time, looking at the parents of the grandparents, and the parents of the great-grandparents, and the parents of the great-great-grandparents. And we could just keep going back in this very linear fashion. In general, you're probably going to find that you're most similar to your parent, and then your grandparent, and then your great-grandparent, as a general rule. But looking at families in this very linear fashion isn't really all that accurate, and it's really difficult to make comparisons to all the other family members that you're related to. Your family actually resembles much more of a shrub-like structure, with branches coming off to the sides, up and to the right, all around, going back in time in many different directions. We can represent half-siblings, aunts, uncles, grandaunts, uncles, cousins, and so on. Let's actually try to look at this, starting with your most immediate biological family members, your parents, father and mother, and your siblings, sister or brother. Now, you share 100% similarity with yourself. Congratulations, you are you. And with all of these other immediate family members, father, mother, sister, brother, you're sharing about 50% similarity. This tier of relatedness is the closest tier of relatedness to you with regards to your family members, those people with whom you're genetically related. Now, let's add the first tier of complexity here. Your mother and father may have siblings. These would be considered your aunts and uncles. Your aunts and uncles and your parents all share parents themselves, your grandparents. This tier of relatedness is roughly 25% to you. This tier also includes relatives like half-siblings. A half-sibling is someone who shares one biological parent with you. Now, you notice that when we added one tier of complexity, we got a lot bigger pretty fast, right? We added a bunch of levels, both in the same generation as you, the generation above you, and another generation beyond that. Now we can add another tier and keep building your family tree or your family shrub in this case. We've added many more great grandparents, some grandaunts and granduncles, some first cousins here. And we can keep building and keep building this tree or shrub, or as I like to think of it, a family rainbow. And we can start at the center here with perfect genetic relatedness and keep moving out to the next rung, to the next part of the rainbow, and we get less and less related. And as we build, we just get bigger and bigger. Our family stretches on in many directions. We're including great-great-grandparents, second cousins, first cousins once removed. This visual really brings to light the shrubbiness of our families and our family trees. Now, with a visual like this, which of the following inferences is the least well described? Would it be family relatedness, genetic relatedness, or trait relatedness? Go ahead and pick the answer you think best applies.